Hello everybody on YouTube, this is Super Nintendo, and welcome back to another episode of The Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time Master Quest. In the last episode, we finished up the Fire Temple. Got ourselves the Fire Medallion. And we also brought our Gold Skulltula count up to 26. We're doing pretty well so far. We've got all the Gold Skulltulas in every dungeon so far. But now, we're going to be going to the Ice Cavern. And this one is going to be interesting because in this dungeon, basically, since this one requires that we carry around a bunch of blue fire, I'm not going to be able to heal through a lot of it, so if there happen to be gold, if there happen to be strong enemies like the Stalfos or Iron Knuckle, then I am screwed. Well, I forgot about you. And that is where the boulder comes from. Remember, kids, this is where baby boulders come from. They come from ceilings. I actually do kind of like how that little alcove is kind of curved. So it kind of looks like the, like, that's the reason why the boulders are being sent out like that. Die, Freezenoid. Rules of nature! And the light when the sun comes out. I do like how they hide a crystal switch near some crystals. Very clever, very, very good. I don't remember very much about... Why is getting ran over with a giant, like, boulder not hurt all that much? Oh, shit. Okay, let's get ourselves pepper. And skadoosh. That wolf wasn't ready to feel the thunder. Neither was that Freezoid. Wait, is that actually what they're called? Freezer. I don't know why I always call them Freezoids, but no, they're Freezerds. Gotta give them the names that they identify with. Why does Navi know what these enemies are called, anyway? Is Navi coming up with the names of these things? Navi, are you insensitive? To monsters. Ah, there is a crystal switch here. But now we don't. Guess we're gonna have to go through the rest of this dungeon very carefully. Be free, Navi Jr. Or Navi the fifth? Dita, what number of fairies are we up to now? You guys are gonna have to excuse me a little bit for coughing. It is allergy season for me. Well, not well, kind of allergy season. My allergies haven't actually been a big problem this summer, but it's summer, so dry air. We got a map, which is borderline useless because we already know where stuff is. Let's get ourselves some more blue fire. Which is much more purpley in appearance, but I guess it's kind of like blueberries. How, like, blueberries, they look a lot more purpley than they do blue. Who's the dumbass who came up with that, by the way? Like, why would you name something that is much more purple blue? Ah! I did not order some Rocky Road. I actually don't care for Rocky Road all that much. Although there is this, brownie brick something. This, like, brownie type of, thing that is really freaking good. Like, there was a point where I was getting one of those, like a tub of that stuff every so... Is this actual water texture, or is this, like, the inside of the sacred realm, the Chamber of the Sages? Huh. There we go. There's a heart piece over there, if you are wanting to get it. Face the power of my explodes. My explodables. We got blue fire! Oh, there is a gold sculpture over there. And because of Navi pointing us in that direction, there is likely a block of time. And indeedly-doo, there is. I wonder if we can get Child Link in here through some kind of editing. Or not editing, but like hacking. I'm sure you can. I doubt he'd be able to do much of anything, though. Yeah, excuse me. In the light when the sun comes out, I burn you alive. Alive! Sorry, I'm gonna be, like... quoting Metal Gear Revising Revengeance whatever songs for a little while. Although I think one of my favorite songs besides Rules of Nature would have to be I'm My Own Master Now. Like that song is so good. It's so good. The boss itself isn't really that great, but like I don't know, like, that song is so fucking good, dude. Alright. Let's head onward. Onward to adventure. Follow the boulder to freedom! Is there something up there, or is that just a graphics glitch? I think that's just a graphics glitch. Alright, let's melt this. And come back over here for some more blue fire. I thought we were gonna need to, cut a lot more in this dungeon, but apparently not. Well, stupid boulders. Dropping in out of nowhere unannounced. Alright, white wolfos. You don't even need to jump attack them. You can just, like... You can just stab them in the butt. Whoop. Wrong song. Alright, let's get ourselves a hooky shotty thing. And a gold sculptula, which, is that the last one in this place? No, it is not. Aha, you thought you could escape me? The answer is maybe. Another white wolfos. The white wolfos in Twilight Princess are really relentless. They are so annoying. Gabber. And I stab you in the butt. Alright, there is another thing over there. And there's a gold sculpture right here. By using the power of the Song of Time?
Gabe, you lied to me. I thought we had a connection.
God damn it. Thought I had my fucking ocarina out. So, one cool thing about blue fire that really isn't all that apparent or really useful, but it's still kind of cool. Blue fire can destroy rocks. I don't know why it can destroy rocks. But it can destroy rocks. Maybe I need to hit that switch again? Maybe? Maybe hitting that switch caused a block to disappear? Yes! Hooray, I figured out the puzzle. I have solved the puzzle. I'm gonna get some more blue fire. I think, yeah, I'm pretty sure that red ice seems to like stay gone. Wait, do we have all the? Yes, we do. Okay. Leave me alone. Demon bats! Okay, Stalfos. May Megaton Hammer? Okay, that was simpler than I thought it was gonna be. I'm sure Stealthos have some kind of weakness that I don't know about, but, yeah. We got the Iron Boots! We meet yet again, Link. If you came here to meet the Zoras, you wasted your time. This is all there is. With one exception, the Zoras are now sealed under a thick sheet of ice. I managed to rescue the Zora princess from under the ice, but she left to head to the water temple. This ice is created by an evil curse. The monster in the water temple is the source of that curse. Unless you can shut off the source, the ice will never melt. If you have courage enough to confront the danger and save the Zoras, I will teach you the melody that leads to the temple. Time passes. People move. Like a river's flow, it never ends. A childish mind will turn to noble ambition. Young love will become deep affection. The clear water's surface reflects growth. Now listen to the serenade of water to reflect upon yourself. I haven't really talked about it up till now, but I love these little sayings that Sheik says about these different melodies. I feel like they are very simple, but very deep when you think about them. Because almost all of these relate to time in some way. That, like he said, young love will grow into deep affection. That is something that happens over time. I'm a firm believer in the idea that love at first sight is not a true thing. I kind of agree with Garnet from Steven Universe that love takes time. Love takes work. You need to know the other person. You can't just and fall in love. That's not how that works. You can have an immediate attraction to someone, but being attracted to someone is not the same thing as love. Then again, I've only had two girlfriends, so what the fuck am I talking about? I don't know. But that's just how I feel on the matter, is that love at first sight is not a thing. It's not a real thing. I think that will do it. Next time on The Legend of Zelda, Ocarina of Time Master Quest, we begin the Water Temple. See you guys then. Let it all out, let it all out. You don't have to think your heart is made of steel. Come away now from your own doubt. Like a flower of hope that's growing in a field, you will heal. Although the road has changed you, and the world has often failed you, you gotta carry on and show them you're strong. You gotta bury what is past and gone. Some days will be worse than others, but you gotta find another way. Yeah, yeah. Through pain and fear, our rain and tears, we will hold on to the light. We'll chase the dawn that waits for us beyond the dark sky. Keep following the distant star. Never walk away from who you are. Never forget that your future's waiting up above.
seasons change and rearrange, and the sands of time descend as all your hopes.